Hello, everybody, and thank you once again for joining us here at the Loveland Living Planet Aquarium as we're bringing the aquarium to you every day at 3 p.m. Today, we're in our Asia Hall, and we've got a couple special guests with us. We've got Kate, one of our animal caretakers, and we, of course, have our binturongs and otters. Now, we were talking with Kate the other day, and we were mentioning that putting animals of different species, or even sometimes the same species, together can be a little bit of a tricky thing. When we had the otters and the binturongs, we didn't just throw them together all at once, did we?
No, we didn't. So we went through a pretty intricate introduction process with these guys. Any of you out there that maybe had to introduce any other animals, it's kind of a similar process. So we started with the binturongs and the otters being completely separate, but they could smell each other, they could hear each other, they knew they were around, but they had no physical contact. The next step we took was kind of letting the otters in and the binturongs in to see each other through some metal mesh, so they couldn't actually engage with each other, but they could still see and smell. And then the final step, and the scariest step, is when you finally let them all together. But leading up to that, we watched their behaviors. We were sure that they're not going to be aggressive with each other. And then when these guys got put together, is before I was here, but I heard it was pretty easy. It's kind of similar to what you're seeing right now. They keep their distance. There might be a little standoff, but in general, the binturongs live up high. The otters live down low, so they keep to themselves.
So it's a fairly similar process to somebody getting a new cat or a dog, adding it to one if they already have it. Slow introduction, getting to know things.
Yes.
Now, these guys get along pretty well for the most part. Mm-hmm. But I do hear that every now and then they steal food or tease each other a little bit.
Yeah, you can see right now Barani is trying to get some of that delicious otter food while they try and get it before he does. So these guys definitely are not friends, but they do tolerate each other and they do live pretty harmoniously. So one of the things we think about when we're putting different species together is where they actually inhabit their physical space. So the otters, like I was just saying, usually they're the ones that are totally on the ground, they're in the water, while the binturongs spend most of their day, if you've ever been here, up in the trees, lounging around. So they're usually completely separate from each other, so they just don't engage. And you'll see a lot of our mixed species exhibits, at least for terrestrial and arboreal animals, follow that same kind of pattern where they literally live in different parts of the exhibit so they don't have to interact with each other. You can see now the otters are pretty quick. They know when Brian's going to swipe at them and run away.
But it's not something that you're ever worried about. You guys keep a close eye on their behavior. And if you ever did see an interaction that was worrying, mm-hmm. you'd be willing to step in.
Yeah, so not to say we're never worried about it. Animals, wild animals are always something that we're a little bit worried about what's going to happen with them. But as you can see here, they've lived together for so long that they kind of know each other's boundaries. There's never been any kind of, there's never been any actual physical contact with them. If it gets too bad, then sometimes we do have to separate them. Usually that's if we put out like a really exciting piece of enrichment. One of them will kind of resource guard it. We might have to readjust how we put out the enrichment. But for the most part, we kind of just let them do their natural animal thing and run each other off. And it's never resulted in any kind of physical harm for either of the species.
You know, I can relate to that. I remember my parents having to set limits on my brothers and I, who gets the computer this time or who can do this. And so very similar to siblings at play, it looks like.
Yeah, actually, that's a pretty good way to put it, that you're not unworried, but at the same time, they live together. You put your boundaries on them and they do okay.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much, Kate, for taking time to tell us a little bit about behind the scenes of how we take care of these animals. We hope that you all enjoyed watching this, and we look forward to you joining us once again every day at 3 p.m. as the Loveland Living Planet Aquarium brings the aquarium to you.